Hey guys, Peter here to do an album review. Today I'm here to tell you about the debut record from Living Dead Girl, Exorcism, out June 11th. This album has 11 tracks, 41 minutes in length, and they are a Canadian rock band. Now, this album has a structure that didn't surprise me. I think considering that this is a debut record, considering perhaps the span of time that it took to create this album, I wasn't surprised that the structure of the record really represents well the eclectic nature of its sound. This is an album that feels almost like a roller coaster ride. I wouldn't say that it is a roller coaster ride because it doesn't have incredible peaks and really deep valleys, but it does have a lot of changes in terms of how the songs are put together, how they're constructed, and how they sound from track to track. And I think they did a wonderful job separating songs that had a lot of similarities at play, so you don't have two songs that feel, sound, or come across in the same nature. Spreading them apart allows the record to feel fresh and reinvigorating with every single track, so you feel like you're getting something different at every single turn. And I think that's important in order to make that eclectic nature of the album kind of dissipate throughout the whole overall construction of the record itself. So I like the structure of the album because it kept me coming back, and it's a record that has incredible fluidity, really incredible playability as well. I mean, you press play, and next thing you know, you're at the end of the record. 11 tracks, 41 minutes also help as far as the amount of songs and the duration. So this is an album that is compact, stretches, but it just flies by. So that really speaks volumes to the quality of the sound and the quality of the overall design and structure of the record itself. Now, once you get into the soundscape, the album is super eclectic. I already mentioned that. I don't think you can define it as just under one genre or under one umbrella. You're gonna see a lot of different elements. You're gonna see tons of pop. You're gonna see rock, pop rock, punk rock, goth rock, metal. Everything is there. Like, it's really hard to define this album because you're gonna see songs that perhaps pull you towards more of one genre than the other, and then you're gonna see some songs that it's a completely melting pot of all of these genres coming together. So there's a lot for the listener to really appreciate, and there's a lot for the listener to gravitate to, considering the amount of different approaches, the amount of different influences that are at play with this soundscape. Almost there's something there for everybody. That's perhaps the best way to define the overall experience of the sound on this record. Now, the other aspect of the sound is one of consistency. While the songs have this eclectic nature because they go in different directions, they have different DNA, they have different fingerprints, the way this album is recorded, the sound quality, the approach, the mixing is phenomenal, top to bottom, and very consistent at that. So this is not a record that you have a couple of songs that have a certain sound signature to them, and then certain songs with a different sound signature to them. So if you're gonna have an eclectic record, you have to have some grounding points, you have to have something that holds it together, that kind of glues it and brings it all as one. I thought the mixing and production on this album was one of those elements. The other ones were the lyrical content and the vocals. Now, the lyrical content is very diverse. It matches the nature of the sound. And I thought that that was an important element because if you're speaking of a specific topic, the sound has to go where that topic is going. The two have to merge together. The two have to become one. They have to really represent each other well in order for the songs to work. But what comes together as far as the lyrical content is concerned is that all the topics throughout this album feel personal. And that's an important element. That's a grounding element. That's something that unifies the record. You may be talking about different topics, you may be talking about different subjects, but the fact that they all seem to come from the same place, from the same origin, really allows the album to feel a little bit more together, to feel a little bit more united. And then on top of that, you have the vocals. Molly Rannick, incredible performance on this debut record. She has an incredible range, she has an incredible voice, and I think the most important thing of all of it is that she can deliver a different performance depending on what the song calls for, depending on the influence on the track. So if you have a pop song or a more of a pop driven track, her voice goes towards that and it matches it perfectly. If the song has a little bit more of a melancholic approach, if it has a little bit more of a goth influence, she goes in down their arena. If the song needs to be a little bit heavier and she needs to bring in some screaming vocals, some harsher vocals, she does that as well. So she really understands exactly her range, what she can do, and what the song calls for, so that her vocals could be an instrument into the track itself. Because let's face the facts, this is not an album that has a tool or that has an element within the soundscape, either be the drums or guitars, that really drives the album forward. This album is driven by the overall vocal performance. Everything else is there to put those vocals on a pedestal. That's how this album is built. This album is built around the vocal. So everything else is happening in order to magnify it, in order to make them more important, and to giving them the spotlight that they deserve throughout the whole record. Overall, I really enjoy this album. Super eclectic, super different from song to song. You really get a lot of different feels, a lot of different looks, and you can expect that from a debut album. I always feel like debut records really represent the growth of the artist from the beginning all the way to the point in which the album is released. It's not like you're going into the studio and you had 2 weeks to record and you had 2 weeks to create this album, so all the songs kind of have a very similar nature or a very similar starting point. Debut albums seem to have a little bit of a different nature to it because they just come from a very different place. This album really feels like that. It really brings it to the forefront. What I would like to see going forward is perhaps focusing more, zeroing down, being a little bit tighter in terms of the spectrum of sound and the spectrum of approaches, so you have an album that feels a little bit more together, that feels a little bit more as one. Now, you can change from record to record what the influences are going to dictate that album to sound like, but within the record itself, I think you have to find your path. I think you have to narrow it down and not just kind of try to do everything at the same time. As far as favorite songs are concerned, I want to start off with Beautiful. Heavy sounding in the verses. The drums and guitars really pack a punch together. They really work well together. And then you get a little bit more melodic, a little bit more pop driven in the chorus. I like the range as far as vocals are concerned. You're going to get screaming vocals, you're going to get raspy vocals, you're going to get clean vocals. This just adds a lot of texture to the sound, it adds a lot of texture to the song itself. But the chorus is really poppy, the verses are a little bit heavy, there's a clear divide between the two. This is a song that has a little bit of an Avril Lavigne style approach to it, so it has a little bit of that Canadian rock punk vibe to it, and I really like that sound, I really like that approach, but you really feel the difference between verses and chorus, and that is what makes this song move. This is what gives the ebbs and flows to the track. Next comes Villain, a very similar song as far as overall structure, as far as having one direction in the verses and a more pop-driven direction in the chorus. I felt the difference between these two is that Villain perhaps has more of a linear sound approach. The sound is not as different. It doesn't break as far apart as it does in Beautiful when you go from verses into the chorus. So there's a sense more of a linear approach, of a fluid approach from one to the other, and the vocals and the style of vocals is really what's creating the main difference between those two worlds. Last but not least, my favorite song on the record, At the Edge. Such a melancholic track all around. I mean, there's ebbs and flows. It's not like it's melancholic all the way through. The guitars and drums at the beginning really set the tone. They really set the mood for what this song is going to sound like. And then the vocals come in and really bring this song down. They descend into this deep sea of melancholy. And it's just absolutely magnificent. It's almost chilling the way the vocals come across on this track. The music behind it really helps define the tempos and the momentums of the song itself. I like the fact that you incorporate heavier vocals with really deep, somber style approach to the vocals as well. So there's a little bit of that yin and yang present in this song, perhaps a little bit more of an introspective moment, and then exteriorizing that moment and putting it all out in the forefront. So it's a song that has a lot to offer, that's really dark, has a dark umbrella, that has a dark shade to it. Very different from everything on this record. There's no other song that even comes close to the sound and experience that this track puts into the forefront. And because of that, because it was so unique, so different, so dark, I really gravitated towards it. I really like her voice, I really like her presence, I really like her tone. And this is a song that strips away all that pop vibe that you're gonna see throughout the record. This is a more goth rock style track, and I just love the sound and I love her vocals in it. That's why it's my favorite song on the record. This is it, Living Dead Girl with Exorcism, out June 11th. Let me know your thoughts on the band, on the singles. Use the comment section below. I'll be reading those and getting back to you. Take care, guys.